the meeting going here. Welcome to the Monday, March the 20th, 2017 Board of Health meeting. Call the meeting to order. I guess I have to hit this, right? Okay. So let's start the meeting, please, by everybody standing up and facing the flag for the Pledge of Allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right. Happy spring, everyone. Yay. So we will start the meeting off by reviewing the February meeting minutes. There were a couple of questions and some highlighted areas, which I just have recently changed and made sure names were spelled properly. And the discussion we had about the Villanova University construction project was taken up by the BOC and the CICD meetings. So I can edit that up so we can make it right. And anybody have any other changes or issues that they saw in the copy they received? No. So we'll look for a preliminary approval of the minutes, and I will get the actual copy to Mr. Taltone so we can get out to the public this week. Anybody have a motion to pass these minutes?
I move we approve.
Thank you. Second. Thank you. And anybody opposed? All in favor, yay. Yay. Meeting minutes from February are passed. I will review those for Mr. Taltone. And that was it the students this week who did these? Was it the students that took notes this week, this month?
Yes, they assisted.
Thank you, students, for assisting. All right, so move on to the next part of the of business in the meeting today would be the health officer's report. And I believe Larry has someone to introduce. Thank you, Larry.
I do, and good afternoon to the Board of Health members and to the residents who are watching tonight. My report for the month of February 2017, we did 23 food safety inspections, 10 bathing place inspections, and 7 quality of life issues. We have a new restaurant that we actually opened up today, which is Jersey Mike's. I like to put those new ones out there to give them a little publicity, at least initially anyway. They're located in the other side of where Giant's located, at 550 East Lancaster, next to Smash Burgers. Shredwich just changed the name. We have with us tonight, I'd like to introduce to everyone, Maria Carbonera, who is our new assistant health officer. Marie has already started working with us doing food safety inspections, and I must tell you that she's doing a tremendous job. She was worth the wait. And I'm hoping that Maria has a couple words that she'd like to say.
Hello. My name is Marie, and I'm working with Larry, and I'm excited to meet everybody. I'm looking forward to this, and so far, I've been here a little over a week, and it's been great. Larry has taught me so much in just the short amount of time that I've been here. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Johnson, for the report, and welcome to Marie. We appreciate the help in our township with its booming businesses and very busy health officers in this township, so we appreciate your help. I think we'll move into some older business and just kind of give everyone in the community some updates about, I guess, just a sort of summarizing what happened at the Villanova CICD meeting, which was held in the beginning of this month, actually at Villanova. It wasn't in this room, so I did not get to attend the meeting. I did watch the meeting on the Radnor TV, and it sounds to me like, and if anybody, you know, watched more carefully, that sounds to me like the decision was made to, the township is going to hire a private or independent, I think it was R2, I believe was the name of the company, a municipal engineering company, to do an independent soil sample and asphalt testing, and then the township will also review Villanova's already done testing because of you know the importance of the size of the project, the locality close to homes and students, and because of the stream nearby. So it sounds to me like the Board of Commissioners approved the funding for that at their meeting, and the CICD at the meeting reviewed that funding and the company that it was that was taking over for that. In addition, there was a lot of talk about how they're removing the asphalt and trying to keep the dust to a minimum and the mess to a minimum. A lot of talk about street cleaning trucks on the inside and the outside of the project there at all times, trying to use backhoes to remove chunks of concrete and asphalt rather than doing it with a stripping machine, which makes a lot more dust. Things are moving very quickly there, so I'm not exactly sure what the time frame is on getting these reports back, but they're certainly moving pretty fast there at Villanova as far as construction. Any other updates?
So I drove past the Villanova University yesterday. It looks like a lot of the surface has been dug up, if I'm not mistaken. Did anybody else see that?
Is there any left?
Sure. I certainly know there's a giant pile of something waiting to go. Did notice that as I was driving by. So I'm not 100% sure on the time frame of anything. Any more updates from the BOC from the meeting on Monday that I wasn't
able to? Well, the only thing I'd add is we also authorized RITU to do testing of the stream that starts in that general vicinity, but also to go down and test, because it's the same stream that goes past McCrone Park. And with all the work we're doing at McCrone, we thought it would make sense to test there also. The last I had heard, the schedule was that they were doing the first storm and then progressing towards Ithan, and I believe all the surface work would be completed by May is what I had heard originally.
Anything about time frame of the testing being done? If there was, has that been, Mr. No.
We authorized them to move, so that's all I can tell you. I mean, that we did not have any authority to slow down or stop Villanova from their work, so.
And that was fairly clear in the meeting that the point of this was to just add an extra layer of safety that, you know, all approvals by the construction company through the all the environmental regulations they have to follow were followed properly, but the size and the location of the project certainly make it reasonable that we're going to do some extra testing and look. And
if I might, I would say that it adds an extra layer of comfort or reassurance. It doesn't add a layer of safety.
I can agree with that. And I can also say that I think as a member of the public of Radnor Township, I think it's it would be helpful for me to see those, you know, the reports and hear the final report and you know, make it, you know, public to everyone so we can all be feel reassured as well. So hopefully that's going to be soon. Student project updates. Does anybody have any updates for us on the projects, guys? Anything new?
Yeah. So currently, I am just continuing to work on my Google Slide presentation, and I'm going to format some posters. And then also, I was talking about using technology with, like, a scanner about, like, facts and information in our high school. So that's what I have. Do you have anything else, Minjung?
Yeah. So my project, I've already actually finished my brochure, and I've already presented them at the high school musical, or musical at the beginning of March. And I just left it there for anybody to take, and nobody took them. But I'll keep trying. I'll be posting them around the school and outside of school.
Have we received a copy yet? Did you guys take a look?
Here.
Oh, awesome. So we'll take a look at that today. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. And then last meeting in new business, or may have been old business because we've been spoken about this a lot of times, we did mention that that the chicken ordinance or approvals would be discussed at the Board of Commissioners meeting. And I actually emailed Mr. Aaron, Mr. Nagel over this between the meetings to make sure that it could be brought up. And I believe it was toward the end of the meeting and it wasn't voted on or anything. We're going to just again, this month, maybe submit a one-page or half a page sort of summary of what we think is the best way to go about, you know, starting the process of approving chicken raising in the township. And before the meeting, we were just discussing a bit, Joan, about, you know, would it be, do we keep it kind of loose and just say, you know, you're allowed to raise chickens and not have regulations, or should there be sort of regulations on how many, how, you know, how large the coop should be, how, you know, these kind of things? Do you have any thoughts on that?
Yeah, I mean, I'm sort of for keeping it deregulated and being more passive on it, and I feel like there's really no good reason not to allow people to have chickens. They're, you know, they're little birds. The township is full of birds. They range between 6 ounces and a few pounds at the most. They're not going to hurt anybody. And it's just not even worth the township's addressing. And there are a lot of animals in this township that people have that actually are more of an issue. We let people have dogs. Dogs are more of a danger than chickens. We have black Angus cattle, you know, 1,500, 2,000 pound black Angus cattle. People have other farm animals. I just think unless there's some rationale, we shouldn't be keeping people from having chickens. And if the commissioners would be more comfortable with an ordinance, then we can do that. Otherwise, I think a laissez-faire attitude approach to the chicken issue would probably be better for most people.
Well, the problem with that position is that our ordinances currently prohibit. So therefore, some action has to be taken. I mean, even if we say, fine, go ahead, we're going to have to change ordinances.
Some action would need to be taken, and maybe just chickens removed from that. So.
Right.
And when we had this discussion initially about 3 years ago, there had been some talk about increases in risks, I guess, of salmonella with chicken, but it's not as, it doesn't seem significant when I read a lot of the recent literature that you're seeing as much of this from wild birds as you are from, yeah, okay. So not a risk there. Anything else that we can think of that would be something that the Board of Health would be concerned with chicken raising? I can't think of many other things. I mean, it doesn't seem like it's too complicated. It probably brings in some predators to the area, which we already have, of course, foxes and maybe some other critters that would eat chickens, but
yeah, I mean, our township is crawling with predators. There's chickens are not going to add to it. There are so many birds in this township that the foxes are eating wild birds, so it's a non-issue, and I don't even know how many people are going to be would be taking advantage of it. To be honest, I think it would be minimal. I think very few people would probably be even taking advantage of it for it to make any impact on the community whatsoever.
So this seems like it should be simple, as we've said many times. So let's try our best again to get this going at the next Board of Commissioners meeting. I don't believe there's any other old business that I had thought of to bring up this month, but if anybody has anything they want to add on, they are welcome to. But I'm looking at last month's meeting minutes, and that covers it. So for new business, I just would like to request, I believe that April, Dr. Pizzi, you got a presentation, thank you. So we'll have a presentation about summer.
Lyme.
Oh, Lyme, cool, okay, great. So be a perfect
Lyme
one. That'd be perfect. So we'll have a Lyme disease talk a bit. And as we know, it's gonna be a rough Lyme season because of the relatively warm winter month we had, not a lot of good hard freeze. I have read some articles recently that we're gonna see, I think, more ticks this season than last. What's that? Lyme disease is an interesting topic that we should all hear the facts about, because there's certainly a lot of other facts on the internet about Lyme disease that aren't true. All right. In the Radnor Township in the spring and the summer, obviously our recs department do an awesome job with outdoor activities for our public, and I did invite someone from the recs department to come. Hopefully I'm over here. Awesome. Thank you. If you guys could just do us a favor and introduce yourself and let us know some of the great things that we're going to see this spring and summer in the township.
Sure. Hello. I am Heather DeCanzio. I'm the Recreation Program Supervisor. I'm here with Tammy Cohen, our Director of Recreation. So thanks for inviting us to your meeting tonight. I just have some general information about our spring programs and events and then our summer program and events. And then I'll be putting the information on the table over there at the end if anyone wants to take the packet with them so you can see a full list of our programs. And then our first half of the year's events are on our event magnet. So in case anyone hasn't had this, you can take it home, put it on your refrigerator, and then we'll be putting out a second magnet with all of our events for the last half of the year. But just to get started with our spring programs, we have a number of programs starting up, but more excited, we have some events coming up. So we have the Spring Extravaganza event, which takes place at Villanova University on their turf field in the stadium there. And that's going to be on April 2nd. Last year, our event was postponed many times and then ultimately canceled because we had very, very bad luck with weather. So hopefully this year we have a more favorable weather situation as long as everything melts in time. And then our next big event after that is the Wheels of Wayne event, which takes place in downtown Wayne along North Wayne Avenue and West Avenue. So that's a very big, big footprint, big impact on the community there. And that's going to be on April 30th. And again, another event that we've been subject to weather, but so far good weather. So hopefully that goes running with, you know, no conflicts there. But really, it's a fun event. It's a car show that takes place, and it draws a really large crowd there in town. And we work closely with the Wayne Business Association for that event. So we're really looking forward to that one. And then our last spring event coming up is going to be the Bike Rodeo. So we did this in 2015. We did not do it last year. It's a biennial event. And that's partnering with the local Boy Scouts to run different stations for bike safety, teaching the kids, you know, different ways of riding their bike and the safety involved with that. And then ultimately a bike ride down the trail. So we're still working with the Boy Scouts to finalize all those details, but then we'll be putting that all together and getting that going. That's going to be on May 7th. So those are our spring events coming up. And then our spring programs, it's relatively light in the spring just because the summer then becomes more robust. And of course, we work closely with the community sports organizations to work on the field scheduling, which really is the main part of the spring programming, so to speak, though it's not run directly through our department. We work with them for in the field needs. But we do a number of sports programs throughout the spring, such as t-ball. We do some junior soccer programs, and then a couple adult programs. We have men's pickup basketball that takes place periodically, as well as we're working with the Philadelphia Sports Leagues. They do a co-ed soccer program at Radnor Memorial, and we're trying to help them increase their number of residents that's involved in that program, Radnor residents, that is, of course. So those are really our spring events. And then the summer, of course, is a very busy season for us. We have a lot going on. Summer programs primarily are camps, but we do have some other sports programs that are more clinic-based, you know, one night a week for a certain amount of weeks. But, of course, we have Radnor Day Camp, which is our six-week day camp program that takes place throughout the summer. We work with the school district for facilities. We go over to Radnor Elementary School for that program. And typically we have anywhere from 230 to 250 campers in that program. And we're hoping to reach that goal of a 250 max again this year. So registration's open and it's been running successfully so far. And then we have our Survivor Nature Hiking program that's been very successful over at the Willows. That's in partnership with the World Cup Sports Academy. And that's another six-week camp program that we partner with them on, and everything takes place over at the Willows. They do a lot of outdoor hiking, creek walks, walking through nature, learning more about the environment out there, and it's been a really successful program over the years. So we've been increasing our numbers and stuff for that specific program. And then another big summer program that we have is an eight-week sports camp that's taking place at the Radnor Activity Center. And this is also in partnership with the World Cup Sports Academy. And it's a multi-sport program, so that'll take place throughout the whole summer for 8 weeks with different sports. So that'll be an indoor-outdoor component there at the Radnor Activity Center and also utilizing the field space over at Radnor Middle School. And then besides those bigger camps, we have a number of more specialty camps. So sports-specific camps like soccer. We'll have some other more less sports-oriented programs such as a theater program, a theater camp. We have a Harry Potter camp and a couple other specialty camps that take place throughout the summer.
And then, of course, our summer events. We have, I guess before we get into summer, we have the memorial, the Carol H. Axelrod Memorial Blood Drive, which will be taking place here at the Township Building, and that's in May. And then after that, we have the Great American Backyard Campout, which is a really fun event. It's been really successful for us over the past couple years, and basically it's open to the public to come and camp out for a night at the Willows Park, and we work with the Scouts and some other local organizations for that one as well. And it's just a great opportunity to get the people in our community out and to experience, you know, the parks after dark when you're allowed to actually be in the parks after dark, and get a chance to, you know, camp basically in, you know, right in your hometown. And it's really a lot of fun, so we're looking forward to that. And then also we have our summer concert. So in the past we've done multiple summer concerts. Last year we did one due to some park projects, and then this year we're also going to just do one because we felt it was really successful last year, and that's going to take place at Beauconner Park, and we're really excited for that as well. We're having the same band come back. They were really well received by the people that came out to the concert last year, and so we're going to be working with them again for this year's concert, and that will be on July 12th at Beauconner. And then as far as events go in the summer, it's actually pretty light, except for the camp out and then the concert, because besides that, we're really focusing on our programs for the youth and the community and a couple adult programs, which really is mainly just the men's pickup basketball. Anything to add on that?
Hi, everybody. Tammy Cohen, Director of Recreation. I just want to say thank you to Heather. She does a remarkable job, and also want to thank everybody tonight for having us here. It's a delight to come and talk to you guys. I know we've shared some emails over the course of the last few years, and it's nice to finally come and get a chance to have some dialogue with you. In addition to some of the great events that we have that are going on, I know we're really hoping, fingers crossed, for having a grand opening celebration at Clemochrome Park. And if we do that, the goal is to maybe tie that in with the 4th of July celebration. So unfortunately, the late winter weather and a lot of the rain that kept us kind of back from some of the major construction during the turn of the beginning of the year has kind of held us back a little bit on that project. But we're looking forward to hopefully getting back on track, you know, once the snow melts here, and hopefully the ground's not soft, but it may be. Just to kind of dovetail, I guess, onto Heather's discussion here on some of the programming, just in regards to the parks, we have a lot of really great park improvement projects, even in addition to Clemochrome. I know we're working on a full park renovation over at Fenimore Woods. We have a couple of other parks on the list, and we have a significant amount of trails that are going to be developed here in Radnor, of course, in the coming years. So we're excited about a lot of things that are happening. We also put a number of renovations into Radnor Activity Center. I know Heather had referenced the camp that we have that's going to go on there during the summer. It's going to be a new 8-week camp. But that facility really looks amazing. For anybody that saw it like a year and a half ago, to walk in it now, it really looks like an all-new location. It's got a fresh coat of paint on the walls, and we have a great new depiction of the floor with the griffin and everything, symbolic, of course, of Radnor Township. So a lot of great recreational spaces here in Radnor, and certainly throughout the programming process, we try and take advantage of all of those. Radnor's really remarkable to have, you know, approximately 30 park and rec open spaces. It's really a lot, given, you know, 13 small square miles. So we really try to do our best in utilizing those. We talked about the survivor camp over at the Willows. We'll certainly give an education to our staff this summer about ticks and kids. I know in February when we had that nice weather, I pulled one off of my son when they were outside running around. It was 70 degrees. So a lot of good stuff there. And then just one of the things to kind of cycle in on, I know we had some exchange over the last couple of years with the Board of Health about concussion protocol. And I know that it was something that Larry had come to me, and I just wanted to revisit it and let you guys know that we took that very seriously. And it's something that we actually incorporated into our structure of training for our staff. And then we work with a lot of contracted programmers too, so we try to make sure that they're aware of the procedures and the protocols that's endorsed by Radnor Township and enforce those as well. Which is something we do take very seriously when it comes to working with our contracted programmers, in addition to the staff that we hire directly, because we kind of have a dual sort of scenario there in terms of how, you know, we work with staff. So anyways, we appreciate your support. We're always looking for partnerships. I know I was excited to hear about Jersey Subs opening up. I know they'll be getting a call from us soon. But anything that we can do with the Board of Health moving forward to work together, any initiatives, you're always more than welcome to come out and represent yourselves as part of the Township and the Board of Health at our community events. We welcome all the members of the community, organizations, and boards to do that, and we'll look forward to continuing that relationship. Thank you.
Thank you. A couple of quick questions, if you don't mind. Are there any opportunities for high school students for employment for these camps in the summertime?
We do have, we, of course, with the Radnor Day Camp, that's the program that we run ourselves, we hire all the staff for. So that program specifically, we would have opportunities potentially for high school students. We do require that all of our staff are at least 16 years or older, but we are currently accepting applications and starting the interview process for our summer Radnor Day Camp program. So there's definitely opportunities there, as well as, of course, volunteer opportunities within some of our programs and our events as well.
Great. And I will give a shameless plug as well to the Carol Axelrod Blood Draw, which is May 9th, Tuesday night. I tend to go every year to donate at that one. That's a good run. And they do a great job making it a pleasant blood draw as well, because it's got lots of gifts and food and nice stuff when you donate your blood. So well worth it.
Foreman, Dr. Foreman. Two things I wanted to add. First of all, I attend a lot of the staff traffic meetings, and something that I know the Board of Health would appreciate is the number of people that come in to get permits for 5K runs. It just, we add one or two every year, it seems. So I think that's very positive. Tammy mentioned the trails. As you may know, we're able to secure $1.75 million in grants for what we refer to as the TAP Trail, which is across Radnor, and we'll actually link up to Haverford and their trails. And then the other thing I wanted Tammy to speak to a little bit would be the Challenger basketball program. That this was the first year for it, and I thought you folks would be interested in that.
Absolutely. Thanks, John. The Challenger basketball program is a new program that we had started just this winter. We actually, our Parks and Recreation Board was approached by the Radnor Committee for Special Education last July, and they are a newly formed organization representing what they claim to be is over 500 families here in Radnor Township that are affected by special needs, a special needs child within their household, which we thought was an astounding number. And working so closely with the Radnor Committee for Special Education, we've been able to develop a series of programming now, you know, in order to be able to cater to the special needs of the children that are being referenced, of course, as part of this group. And living here in Radnor Township, we've had a significant amount of experience with some of the families through our Radnor Day Camp program, so a lot of them we became familiar with. But we were able to launch our first basketball program, where we had two instructors leading the program and doing like basic skills and drills and training on Wednesday nights, and then having games on Sundays. And it was so highly regarded. I wish I could capture the video that we have and we're in the process of making here for you guys tonight, and we'll make sure that we cycle back in with that. But it really, from a social and developmental standpoint, it really, in my 18 years of being here, it really was one of the most remarkable moments on Sunday, seeing it all kind of come together. We kind of had like a last day celebration of the program where we gave out trophies. We recognized all of our volunteers, and we even had the boys and girls high school basketball teams come, and the coaches as well, and they took part in the program as well. They actually played the game against the kids, and they loved it. So I think our kids won like 86 to 30 something, but it was a blast, and the families really enjoyed it. And we've been able to develop a really great relationship with the Radnor Committee, which is an independent group. It doesn't operate out of the high school or the school district in any way. They're their own newly formed organization, and you know, we've been trying to work with them, get them going. I know they're having some of their meetings here in in the township building now on a monthly basis. But like I said, I think one of the most astounding things is the amount of families that are being represented as part of this group. And I know our department has some major goals and objectives over the course of the year to continue working with them. We were hoping to make a bridge with Radnor Wayne Little League and open up some baseball, softball type programming in the spring. We're working with Radnor Soccer Club to do some soccer programming, again, specific challenger-based programming. And then we have some ideas for this this upcoming spring as well as the summer and continuing to work with the parents. I know getting around to talk to a lot of them, having the structure and the opportunity for the kids, as well as just the social opportunity, has really been amazing for them and very well received. So I appreciate Commissioner Nagel, you acknowledging that, because it really is a great program. I know Heather had poured her heart and soul into making sure this program went well, and you know we couldn't be more proud to be part of it with the organization and looking forward to growing with it.
Thank you so much, Sam. We appreciate it. All right. Thank you guys for coming. So before we get out of new business for my my board here, I think we should just set up two reps for each of these little issues that over the next month we can get these sort of settled and out. So one would be if someone could sort of take charge again for just a brief half page kind of recommendation for the chickens, possibly to be just presented to via email to the Board of Commissioners by their second Monday of the month meeting, I guess. Is that okay, Joan? Could you start that process? And maybe you could work with another person on the board just to kind of bounce it back and forth, and then we can get that sent to me, and I can send it out to Mr. Nagel or to Mr. Ayer or whoever, to Mrs. Schaefer, but just to, so it's brought up at the second Monday of the month meeting with the Board of Commissioners. And the second thing would be, and I'm certainly willing to take charge of this one if someone else wants to work with me a bit, is I think that we've heard a lot in the last couple of years. First of all, a lot of scientific information that I've brought to the meeting and some other people have given to me to bring to the meeting, and also a presentation last month about sleep recommendations for teens. And I think it would be a good idea for the board to just state their position to the school board, that this is something that they should start to consider and look into in a more formal fashion. That is our opinion. Again, put this in real words when we get it on paper, but the opinion is, and at least my opinion is, I'll see if my board agrees with me if we try to approve this before we present it to the school board, is that you know the teenagers would do much better with a different sleep pattern and with getting better sleep before school, and certainly there's ways to get that done. It might be difficult, but it should be able to get done. So I think a little recommendation to the school board from the Board of Health would be an excellent way to do that, and we can all discuss the pros and cons of that when we can get a recommendation together. So I'll take charge of that. Does anybody else want to work with me on that one? Any have any interest in school sleep? You will? Okay, Nancy. Thank you very much, and helping me out with that as well. So we'll contact via email through the month, and by next meeting have something we can approve as a board. But I think the chicken thing, we don't need to approve again. We've approved that a number of times as a board, and we can just get that over to the Board of Commissioners. Okay. Any other new business anyone has to bring up? Anything that's come up this month? No? Okay. So on to some announcements, and then we'll get to some public participation. Just to let everybody know about the flu, we are ending or getting toward the end of flu activity. As we, the U.S. showed in the week of 3.5 to 3.11, a trend on decreasing activity throughout the U.S., although we're still in flu activity, high activity season, it is decreasing over the last 2 to 3 weeks. There have been 6 pediatric deaths this year from the flu. It's sometimes difficult to get real calculations on adult deaths considering the flu is a virus that triggers other illnesses and exacerbates other chronic illnesses. So the exact numbers of deaths from the flu in adults is a difficult number to come by each year. But the CDC will put something out in a few months, I'm sure. The flu vaccination this year looks to be similar to last year, about 50 to 52% effective to the flu A strains that are around. The flu B strain was a good match this year. So the flu vaccine continues to be a good tool, but not a perfect tool against the fight against the flu. Still recommending that people get the flu vaccine seasonally. I think we're a little late in the season for it this year, but certainly keep your thoughts about that as we get to late August, early September of 2017. March is National Nutrition Month, and the CDC does recommend four major points. One is decreasing sodium and looking for low-sodium products, increasing fiber in our diets, which is probably one of the harder things to do, but certainly one of the most beneficial. Whole-growing foods like fruits and vegetables obviously contain a lot of fiber, as well as whole grain foods. Putting more colors on our plate, which would be the fruit and vegetable thing, of course, and then adding in healthy fats to our diet, which was probably something that's a little bit newer thought to some people, but nuts and avocados and eggs and other things that have healthy fats in them are actually very good for us. And the whole trend in the early 80s and 90s to go low fat has been shown to not be very successful, and the federal government is beginning the process of making it more public that we should probably get more fat in our diet that are, you know, non-saturated fats, things like nuts, avocados, eggs, and some other ones. That's all the big announcements I have. Anybody else? Any other announcements? Nothing. Okay. On that, we will see then if there's some public participation. Please come to the microphone, introduce yourself, and we're glad to listen to your opinions.
Good evening. Roberta Winters, 326 Williams Road. I just wanted to thank the Board of Health for raising awareness about potential problems that arise with large-scale development, particularly with air quality, and I think hopefully it's a lesson we've all learned, and we can look forward to continued advocacy and more proactive on the parts of our township in the future as we look at development as it moves down Lancaster Avenue and beyond. I would also like to thank you, Dr. Foreman, and other members of the Board of Health for your interest in adolescent sleep needs and your potential action. I wanted to alert you that Representative Tim Briggs has introduced legislation in Harrisburg. It's House Bill 762, I believe, which is calling for a state study to look at the evidence to change perhaps school start time and any of the consequences, be they intended or unintended, that might result from that. So I think it's something to watch and something to encourage. And if we perhaps in the future have a resolution that might come through the Board of Health to bring to the Department of, to the House Education Committee to perhaps have our legislature consider that, it would be a wise thing to do. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ms. Winter. Any other public comments? Okay. And again, with the activities this spring and summer, I'm hoping that board members will volunteer to come out and participate in these activities and maybe see if anyone has any public comment for us at these larger events. I know it's been difficult in the past. Nancy's tried it in the past, and I've tried it once before, but sometimes people have something to say, so we'll try to get out there and be exposed to them. Okay. Being that there's no more public participation, we can adjourn the meeting and regroup here on Monday, April 17th at 5:30 p.m. in the Radnor Room. Thank you very much for attending, everyone.